Only one person stands in the way of Donald Trump's Republican Party nomination this morning after Ron DeSantis withdrew from the race. Trump and Nikki Haley will face off in the New Hampshire primary in the next 24 hours.
Joining us for more is former White House Director of Events Laura Schwartz, live now from Chicago. Laura, always so good to see you. So tell us what the reaction has been to DeSantis' withdrawal. There was a lot of hype around him.
There sure was, and it's so great to be with both of you and all the viewers today. You know, DeSantis kicked off last May to a lot of glitches. He announced on Twitter, he raised a ton of money, he was supposed to be the golden child and take on Trump, and now here we are in January. It's calculated that he spent about $2,263 a vote because of his poor showing in Iowa, and now that he's skipped out of the race, it looks like maybe Trump got a 2-point bump, maybe Haley got a 2-point bump. Poor Ron DeSantis didn't seem to make much of a difference after dropping out last night.
All right. I mean, is anyone really going to stand in Trump's way, realistically?
No, I don't think so, Carl. Trump's got this. And even among, like, the Republican primary overall electorate, he's at, like, 70%. So he's just going to take down state by state. Nikki Haley's competing, of course, in New Hampshire. She got a big infusion of cash. I will say that. She's fundraised about $500 million in the last... I'm sorry, $500,000. Big difference.
Bit of a difference.
Over the last few days. So it's enough to, like, keep her chugging along. And after New Hampshire in a few weeks comes South Carolina. That's her home state. She was governor of South Carolina. Mm. Although the members of Congress from South Carolina have already endorsed Trump, and he's ahead there. But, you know, I give her credit for fighting on. And if they, as a campaign, can do it with the cash on hand, and I don't think I'd say stay competitive, but just maybe pursue some delegates down the road. Mm. You know, I could see her staying in for a few more weeks.
Yeah, what is her game plan? Because it's clear she can't beat Trump.
That's correct, Sarah. You know, in every state, you collect delegates. She got 7 out of Iowa. Trump got 20. You need about 1,215 to clinch the nomination. Now, she's not going to get anywhere near that. But I think her campaign feels now that if she can just stay in and maybe get a couple more delegates here, a couple more delegates there, and then if Trump could have a big problem with one of his possible convictions, if there are any trials this year, that people might go to her. I mean, that's kind of one game plan. There's also this third party sort of thing here in America called No Labels. We'll be talking a lot more about that, I think, in the coming months. Kind of casting themselves as the independents, and they're looking for a candidate, so they could ask Nikki Haley to come on board. They've got some money. Maybe she can run with them. But I think she's just going to take it tomorrow and to South Carolina, and then we'll see.
All right. I think we see the writing on the wall already, on the White House wall.
I do too. Trump.
Thank you, Laura.
Thank you, Laura. Love your work.
Former President Donald Trump's campaign is headed back to New Hampshire this morning after a very brief courtroom appearance in New York. Let's go live to US correspondent Jonathan Kersley, who's in Concord in New Hampshire. Jono, minutes after Trump arrived, court was cancelled for the day.
It was more courtroom drama for the former president. This time in New York, he was there for the defamation trial brought by the writer E. Jean Carroll. He's already been found liable for sexually abusing her, and today it was possibly a chance for him to take to the stand. His lawyer has suggested that he wants to do that. However, twists and turns inside that courtroom. A juror sick, his lawyer not feeling too well either, so the judge adjourned hearing for the day. It does now mean that Donald Trump could get up here to New Hampshire a little bit earlier than perhaps he was anticipating. He's due on stage with supporters not too far from here later on this evening. A final push for votes in the crucial Republican primaries ahead of those votes taking place tomorrow. The Republican race, now a two-person race. Donald Trump up against his former UN ambassador, Nikki Haley, who herself has been out on the campaign trail in this very town, not too far from where we are now, trying to win over not only the Republican base, but crucially undeclared voters. There's about 340,000 of them or so in this, the Granite State of the United States of America. And there's one very important question facing not only voters here in this state, but voters right across the country as Donald Trump firms as the Republican nominee.
If he was the Republican nominee, would you vote Democrat?
Yes, I would not vote for Trump. I would not vote for Biden either. So I guess I wouldn't vote.
So So that's the problem both Donald Trump and Joe Biden have now, is to try and win over those crucial undeclared voters. A comfortable win for Donald Trump here tomorrow would very much cement his standing as the favourite for the Republican nomination. Democrats also voting here tomorrow, Brooke, a chance for them to put a name beside, a mark beside Joe Biden. It is likely that this could well be a presidential rematch come November this year.
All right. Thanks, Jono.